for heaven. This thing they happen, happen to anyone. Happen to anyone. I live the life that I love. I love the life that I live. Tomorrow is not promised, but I'll keep the things that I need. Love is in the air. Yeah, face mask. No matter, it matter. I'll be rich till I die.
Book 2 of page 162, hymn number 222, hymn number 22.
Soul of my Savior, body of Christ, be thou my saving guest. Blood of my Savior, bathe me in thy tide. Wash me with water flowing from thy side. Strength and protection, may thy passion be. Oh, blessed Jesus, and answer me. Deep in thy hide and shelter me, so shall I never part from thee.
Life, and that they who conquer imputation shall have your heritage, for you will be their God, and they your children. We know, Lord, you can do all things, and no purpose of yours can be hindered. We are your disciples, baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Therefore, to you, Lord, be blessed and honor and glory and might forever and ever.
Amen.
Confession of sins. O God of men, O God, all men have sinned and fallen short of your glory. How can the young keep his way sinless?
By keeping God's commandments.
Your hands, Lord, made and fashioned me. Give me understanding that I may lay your commandments. Gracious is the Lord, and righteous our God is merciful.
Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
The commentaries. The apostles were arrested after curing the lame man at the beautiful gates. The Sanhedrin were in dilemma on what to do to the apostles, to kill them or to let them go. Sometimes people have called you bad names or accused you wrongly of going to church or Sunday or not following a bad gang. Once you know the right thing, to do, where God will be pleased with you. Always face it with courage. Reflection. Do the right and fear not, for God is always pleased with honest people. You taught us that through prayers and fasting, we shall get rid of our infirmities. We remember those who are in need at this time, that through your divine intervention, they may be delivered from the physical and spiritual forces that disturb their welfare with everlasting grace, that they may be restored from their problems, being spiritually fortified, they may face the world with joy. We make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Oh,
morning, students. I am so happy. I cannot fathom the joy within me this morning standing with you. It reminds me of how we used to do it 30 years back. I am pleased to inform you that the people you have in your midst this morning are the class of 1997 sets of the Old Boys Association, CKC. We are marking our 25 years out of school. Actually, it was last year, but because we want to fix the logistics and we want to get everything right as we used to have it, that we are first among equal as we accommodate it now pretty much into Paris. We have to now shift it as to get everything right to this very year. And by the special grace of God, we are standing before you celebrating with you because we want to have that feel again of how we used to have it that far in 30 years back. And that is why we are standing there by means that they do not all of us are here, a few of us that are around are standing with us. You can see them standing in their white or white. You know, we used to clock swim then. That was why we are appearing on our long sleeves, and I am surprised seeing the seniors on their short sleeves, but not this point. I don't know, do we have our brother, Ikechukwu Aligo?
On the way.
Please, can I humbly invite Mr. Tony Egonu?
Meanwhile.
Good morning, the principal. Good morning, teachers of Christ the King College, Onitsha.
Continue.
I will.
Has he now done?
Title the very brief talk for this morning. That today is the first day of the remaining part of your life. I must say that it gives me great joy whenever I have the privilege to stand before young people, to stand before people of your age, for the singular reason that I know, and you will also agree with me, that we have presidents of this great nation standing in your midst. We have governors of this great state, governors of the states in Nigeria standing in your midst. So I count myself privileged to be standing to address you this very morning. And I believe you all deserve a round of applause. Thank you. At the same time, inasmuch as I am privileged to be addressing you this morning, I must also say that you are privileged to be students of this prestigious institution. Students of this prestigious school, the Christ the King College. I'm sure you know how much people aspire. I'm sure you know how much people strive to attend this noble college. You should count yourself privileged. And it's a privilege that you shouldn't, for any reason, take for granted. I must say, the things you've been going through, that you are even more privileged than we are, because then we had the option of being day students. But here, you all brothers, it's a double privilege. It's an added advantage that you shouldn't, for any reason, take for granted. If you know all the things you go through in the boarding house, if you know all the grooming stages you go through as students of this school, you shouldn't discard any of them. You should continue to do what your teachers, what your parents, what your seniors that you feel that, I'm sure to some extent some of you might think that people disturb you, yes, because of your age. I must stand there to tell you this morning that that is your grooming period. That is your the period you should hold in very high esteem, because those were the things that made us who we are today. Without wasting time, I will quickly call my classmates then in 1997, who will, in 5 minutes, also address you this morning. I have the singular honor and privilege to invite to this stage Uche Aligo, who we call Aligo Mom.
I'm sure you must have been hearing about Aligo Mom over the air. You are seeing him live here, and he is from this school. We have doctors, we have engineers, and we have plenty of them.
OCKC! 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 Primus! Primus! Good morning, everybody. I think it's better than you know what we got when we were here. And we say thank God for that because in Nigeria, most unfortunately, whenever we discuss in all sectors, we come to see that yesterday is always better than today. And for me and for everybody who is progressing, that is tragic. But thank God for CKC. Perhaps we are improving. Even us living in Onitsha, people living in Nnewi, Aba, Ibiamabia, Umuaka, Obuna, Nwatakịrị amụrụ ọhụrụ na primary school adịghị anyị Igbo, living in Onitsha, sometimes you wonder why should we be doing so. However, during our own time, we speak Igbo mostly. When we come to CKC, then it became a challenge. Only those boys that came from Lagos. However, it's nice that children learn, you know, all languages that they could learn at any point in time, because a child has the ability to learn, even take as much as 36 languages at the same time. However, what I've just said now is for the teachers. It's always nice to teach them in both ways, especially mathematics, if you ask me. Principal, we must continue using maths. Do we have our math teachers here?
Yes.
Only one person?
Math teachers.
Only one? Principal, I don't know. Because one of the problems we are facing in this country currently is that not love for mathematics. If you ask children here, many people will say, Amaro Mass, Adema like here. Why I thought what caused it was because perhaps the teachers that first taught us, maybe the first generation, the second generation, did not understand exactly. At that point, they didn't understand exactly what they were doing. So they were just teaching for the sake of let's teach and earn this money and get away. And it's a problem. For me, this thing, we could make our children love it if we can teach maths, even in Igbo language. That's how my mother taught me. She was a teacher. First learning was Igbo. You know, so that if we are going to, for example, looking at this roof now, I know that this roof has to do with the point of elevation and depression. Manu no bara class, una ara kuzi a bit ko fu, a bit fu ko. What they call it now? Something vague, abstract. But when you use things around you to teach, these children get you. Why am I saying this? This is how you get logical citizens. When maths is well taught, children will get to know, if I get good logic and become logical citizens. And when we have citizens that are logical, that is how we say that we now have an educated society. One of the problems we have in Nigeria, and perhaps many places in Africa, that people are not really educated, despite the certificates. We have a very dysfunctional society because we have a dysfunctional education system. And this thing has its foundation in no law for maths and teachers that don't understand what they are teaching, but they are just doing it. If you are a principal, I will plead with you. The government ideas that even if there will be a strike, at least we on the side of the alumni can help. But we can go out and recruit people that love maths so that these children will now, from the very beginning, have love for it and begin to build so that we have a better educated society. Students, I hope there are still discipline in this school.
Apo mo azizi na tambo na eba. Una wakebe tambo. Una anata. Ne tambo ya gugu. Magamwa ndi tambo. If only I was here for you, we would need a group. But thank God for life, you know. That is doing exam malpractice. So these things are things of the past, right? They are no longer obtainable here. And thank God, please clap for yourself. Whatever you do in life, always remember that you have a reputation to protect, and it has to do with the name of your alma mater, and that is CKC.
When you do bad things, people refer, you know, back to CKC and it will give us bad name. Because of that, because you are meant for greatness, because we prepare you for here for greatness, I will encourage you at all times to make sure that you have the name of our college CKC at the back of your mind whenever you're doing anything, so that you don't bring our soul to disrepute.
Good morning, the principal, the deputy manager, seminarians, teachers and students, and also all boys of Next Tech 7 set. Good morning to all. As already inculcated by the Archbishop Valerian Maduko KK, one can't attain beatitude without the attitude of gratitude. So it is most fitting as I, as the deputy senior prefect of Christ the King College, on behalf of the entire students and family of CKC, extend my unalloyed estimates of gratitude to you all, the old boys of 1997 sets. We pray that you all are successful in all your endeavors in life. And our promise and prayers as the students of CKC are that you are going to be the fine students of this college. We pray that we achieve our aim of coming to this college. Of CKC.
Thank you so much. There's not going to be enough of the attitude without gratitude. Thank you.
The alumni class of 1997, as already expressed by the deputy senior prefect, this college, which belongs to all of us, this college in which you are also stakeholders, appreciate your visit today. It is always a thing of joy and encouragement for us, especially for the young ones coming up, to see our alumni visit us, encourage us. CKC can boast of a body of alumni that is second to none in the whole federation. I was privy of the alumni of King's College Lagos and alumni Doba, DMGS, and I keep getting more convinced that we are the primus. The only school that is competing with us is CIC Enugu in terms of alumni participation and devotion and dedication to the alma mater. So we are grateful for your visit, we thank you immensely, and we expect that you continue to be around whenever you can. Now, they have promised to give us an exquisite lunch. Take care. So, I don't need to tell you that this lunch is not cooked. Another interesting thing this afternoon is that we are going to use that opportunity to open our new refectory. All the teachers are invited to eat lunch with us. All the teachers. Every teacher will be in the ref. When we get there, you will find your table. The staff, you will see your table for making our time to visit us. Thank you, mes étudiants. Vous êtes très heureux ce matin. Vous avez mangé ce matin très bien.
Quelqu'un est capable de comprendre la français? Hein? Alors, qui entre vous peut venir ici pour remercier un? Qui entre vous en français? Qui entre vous?
On avait vous remercier pour la bonne nourriture que vous nous donnez.
Thank you very much. We are now going to go back to our classes and the band will give us a nice beat as we march to our classes.
Come on, see where we are last.
Okay, one of you come and sing.
All right, band. Band. Trumpet. Band. Okay.
Anna, that inside that place there's a consulting room.
Okay.
Then he may be in the
I don't want no
Thank you. Electricity, vibes on a frequency, yeah. Till infinity, steady on a different thing. Life is not dirty, it's all about the energy, yeah. The mentality, now you make it my body. Nobody go inside.
Eucharistic celebration in honor of the 1997 set of CKC Old Boys. We thank God for the grace and for His blessings upon you. We thank God for the blessings that He has bestowed on our beloved college. And we pray that through this Mass, that God will continue to bless us, that God will continue to bless you, the alumni of this college, that God will continue to bless the present students of this college, that God will continue to bless our families and our friends and all that are dear to us through Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Through my fault, through my
our contemplation of the Lord's passion and our service of your church. Grant that through our intercession, your people participating in the mystery of Christ may ever exalt in the revelation of his glory. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. From the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, the apostles and the brethren who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcision party criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to the uncircumcised men and eat with them?" But Peter began and explained to them in order, "I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision, something descending like a great sheet, let down from heaven by four corners, and it came down to me. Looking at it closely, I observed animals and beasts of prey, and reptiles and birds of the air. And I heard a voice saying to me, 'Rise, Peter, kill and eat.' But I said, 'No, Lord, for nothing common or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But the voice answered the second time from heaven, 'What God has cleansed you must not call common.' This happened three times, and all was drawn up again to heaven. At that very moment, three men arrived at the house in which we were, sent to me from Caesarea, and the Spirit told me to go with them, making no distinction. These six brethren also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. And he told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, 'Send to Joppa and bring Simon, called Peter. He will declare to you a message by which you will be saved, you and all your household.' As I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell on them, just as on us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he said, 'John baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If then God gave the same gift to them as he gave to us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could not withstand God?" When they heard this, they were silenced, and they glorified God, saying, "Then to the Gentiles also God has granted repentance unto life." The word of the Lord.
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me?
How can I repay the Lord for his good to me? How can I repay
healing, his doctrine, many of the followers of Jesus said, "This is intolerable language. How could anyone accept it?" Jesus was aware that his followers were complaining about it and said, "Does this upset you? What if you should see Son of Man ascend to where he was before? It is the spirit that gives life. The flesh has nothing to offer. The words I have spoken to you are spirits, and they are life. But there are some of you who do not believe." For Jesus knew from the outset those who did not believe, and who it was that would betray him. He went on, "This is why I told you that no one could come to me unless the Father allows him." After this, many of his disciples left him and stopped going with him. Then Jesus said to the 12, "What about you? Do you want to go away too?" Simon Peter answered, "Lord, who shall we go to? You have the message of eternal life, and we believe, we know that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Amen.
Up CKC.
Up CKC.
Up CKC.
Up CKC.
May you say it. A brief reflection, very brief. In the Gospel just read, the people, the Israelites, they were arguing, almost arguing with Jesus Christ. And at the point, Jesus said to them, "It is the spirit that gives life. The words I have spoken to you are spirits, and they are life. The words I have spoken to you are spirits, and they are
life."
They are what?
Life.
They are life. No more. The words I speak to you today, they are spirits and they are life. Many of you, the alumni of the college, as you are looking at me today, I know that you remember how in your own time the principal, I believe Father Musu, okay? As you are looking at me, you will be remembering.
Lunch. In the center, we call it heavy lunch.
You showed us that you care and that you love us. I want to thank you. Because the Archbishop will always say that gratitude, like the case you said yesterday, that you cannot attain gratitude if you don't have the attitude of what? Gratitude.
It's not real.
That if I love you, if I'm grateful to you, but I don't express that gratitude, then that gratitude is not real. So for coming back after these years to express gratitude to this college, I want to thank you today. And I pray that your coming back to this college will bring immense blessings to you and to your families through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Take this all of you and bring from it. For this, the church is my blood,
the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which you poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Valerian, our Bishop, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. So we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit the glorious eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. In and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
CDC that started in 1955, we are not producing. outcome school that was started in 1933, they have produced two governors. And they want to produce three governors, yeah, what they need. And they also want to produce Mr. President. We are jealous. How I wish that this is also my alma mater. I don't know how many of you that has contested for anything politically. This young man, since I think you have contested for chairmanship of the local government, about and God will lift you. Finding me worthy to be here with you today to share this occasion. Thank you. God bless Anambra State. God bless 97 cents. God bless all of you. There is no way I can live here without encouraging you. Though in your listening, I did not see the donation. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Guests, speakers, friends, family, and most especially my boss of the 97 states. See, none of us here gathered from all around Nigeria and beyond makes me happy. This was made possible by our silver jubilee celebration. We've been gathering, attending functions, visiting each other and having fun. But this is different. It is the homecoming of brethren. It creates the opportunity and avenue to meet and reunite with our friends. Through these, more relationships will be born. Deeper bonds will be shared and created. And business connections established. It's all to the glory of God that through these days, boys have evolved into men and have become big players in all facets of life endeavors. We have doctors, pharmacists, lawyers, engineers, surveyors, valuers, academians, builders, economists, representatives of men, captains of industries, etc. I must commend our Silver Jubilee Anniversary Committee for their hard work and dedication, and also the entire 97 State of the CKC Old Boys Association for their strong support, financially, morally, and otherwise, in making sure that we have an outstanding event. Truly, we've really improved, both in size and debt. Knowing where we came from, when our pioneer chairman, Leon Udoh-Lisa Ebuka, first started this journey to bring us together under one umbrella, no one ever thought we could be this good. But through your strong support and active participation, we've been able to do many charity work, caring for our members in need in difficult times. We've also built and delivered a basketball court to our alma mater. To wrap it up, we've also put together a magnificent list of speakers to deliver quality lectures on health, relationship, and finance to us on this silver jubilee. Wait for it. Once again, I sincerely welcome us all to our event, the 25th anniversary of the 1997 State of CKC Foundation, our silver jubilee. May the good Lord guide and protect us all in Jesus' name. Amen. Hope you are all hidden as Samuel. Properly known as Bruno. Thank you very much.
Yes, I thank you, my brother. And perhaps the newly acknowledged needs, such as healthcare, education.
education, both formal and informal education, security and things like that. The students were contributing along these lines. So a responsible man must have as companion, must have it as a woman and companion.
In the 97, right?
Changed this with his own celibate life, which was an example for his disciples, such as John and St. Paul. And as St. Paul clarifies, life of celibacy, commitment to God, in a relationship of love, and is also a service to humanity. So, since then, therefore, in the New Testament, we have this order of priesthood and religious, which constitutes another type of relationship which provides the relationship of marriage as a sole relationship for human beings. Right? Because that is what most I can see most of you involved. In the past, especially in Igboland, if we mentioned marriage and relationships, what visually and romantically think of marriage between man and a woman, between men and women. All this has changed in the past few decades. And people speak openly now about same-sex marriage and relationships. During this, I would like to stick mainly to the positions of the Catholic Church and the Igbo tradition. Begin with the data. Homosexual relationships were considered our abomination. Perceived to be out of the natural order, we are considered to be out. And this was a particularly big one. If this traditional Igbo morality was like biblical Jewish morality and European cultures, where homosexuality was widely accepted and practiced. There was nothing remotely close to the Greek, Roman, or Canaanite acceptance and practice of homosexuality in Igboland and Nigeria in general. We see Europe is a zooming of this common intellectual practices to the wider social life and society. With the coming of the Renaissance in Europe, which was a revival of the Roman culture, and the reference to this culture as a justification for some modern practices, it seems to me that one of the results will also be a revival and acceptance of the practice of homosexuality, which centuries of you reject and suppress. Nigeria, however, homosexuality does not have public acceptance because it does not have a culture, religious, legal, or scientific act in the eyes of the public. I shall therefore not discuss this further. What I'm meaning here is that unlike pre-Christian European culture, where these practices were accepted, where they existed in their temples with vows and ashes, Sodom and Gomorrah, and all those things, we didn't have the same here. And so we can't begin to discuss it because they are discussing the people that was polyamorous. Those who can afford to marry one and one wife, as a matter of wealth. And as a matter of wealth, if you are not paying to 40 wives, then you are regarded as a woman. All is okay with the dominance of the Christian notion of marrying a woman. Before we go into this relationship, let us note that polygamy is returning to the West in the so-called polyamorous relationship. Here, one and two persons consent to living together in shared sexual relations because the law of bigamy remains in the Western state codes. So, only two of such persons may be legally married. The others are informal arrangements. But they all live together. We still have doubts that we cannot accept the West, that the West will lead us like those. We have to formulate our own standards and norms based on the fusion of Christianity and your culture, which, in such a way that we can have a universal and viable standard. What then is the idea of marriage in Christianity, especially in the Catholic faith? inconsolable union of a man and a woman. Jesus made that clear in saying that God created the male and the female. And for this reason, a man will leave his family and join himself with his wife, both will become one body.
When I
say Christ elevated marriage on the level of a sacrament, through which the will of God is manifest in the world, and through which we can get in contact with God, through which God dwells in us and blesses us. At this point, we need to clarify what we mean by God.
I need to have multiple streams salary to come.
Please, let the man be on the season, this business is for dry season. I don't believe in seasonal business. What do I mean by that? I have businesses I can do in any season. I have businesses I can do in dry season. So you better develop yourself in that way. Spend it. We are thinking about what sources of income in a nutshell, but what of the spending? It is good that one knows how he gets income and how he spends it. How you get income and how you spend it matters a lot. Try and a success drive and be intentional about the way of the finance. If you want to be financially intelligent, I say you will first of all develop a success drive and be intentional about the well-being of the finance. You should be a progressive person, a person who want
to succeed.
You should determine that I will succeed.
The second thing that you will do if you want to be financially intelligent
is that you will try to seek knowledge and be well informed. Seek knowledge and be well informed. Like I told you, I'm into
water engineering, water exploration.
And I know that plumbing is connected to water engineering.
You must seek knowledge and be well informed. Number three, this one is better.
Number three, you must try as much as possible to make use of what you have learned. I have told us I have learned how to do plumbing and I'm constantly taking use of them. You must take track of your spending.
I love this spontaneously. And I stand horizontally parallel to the wall. I'm vertically perpendicular to the ground now. I only think of you since you are a fantastic and fabulous girl, put together as fantabulous. That's a measure of fabulous and fantastic. My metabolism suddenly halts, and my peristalsis goes in reverse gear. My medulla oblongata also ceases functioning. Crazy, you may say, but this is very, very terrible. If only you knew what is going on in my and some follow, you will prostrate. That's why I need to see you vis-a-vis soon for a better elucidation to a certain attempt. That is yes. Only you and me are protagonists in this whole affair. As I go to death, I will be next.
You can just lock your office and be there just for some moments, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, depending on your schedule. Come back, please. Eat small plant-based foods. Number four, get regular physical exercise. Number five, eat more whole grain bread and cereals. Six, choose healthy fats, e.g. omega 3 and others. Seven, achieve and maintain a healthy weight. Eight, maintain good mental health by avoiding dependence on illicit drugs and alcohol. Observe good moral and spiritual health. 11. Ensure adequate pathological health. 13. Avoid indiscriminate antibiotic consumption. Maintain standard social health. 14. Work towards adequate financial health. 15. Achieve standard environmental health. 16. Keep a good occupational and vocational health. Lastly, number 17. Avoid self-medication. Let me just quickly take the above attributes one by one. Number one, adequate sleep. Enough sleep is necessary for the body metabolic processes to realign and reset for the next day activities. Sleep enhances the brain cells, relaxes the muscles, and optimizes the body developmental processes through peristaltic actions, heartbeat, based by the sinoatrial node of sleep, either compulsorily or intentionally. That is who work day and night, or people abroad that stay true to that. Well, some of you may not know this, but those who read much earlier will tell you that in only as 30 minutes of quiet time, private hour. I remember in my secondary school days, during his private hour, he doesn't sleep, but you can't see him, whoever you are.
I wear black, you wear white.
Numbers-based foods. Remember the topic is on towards good health and longevity. Number three, manganese, trace elements. Some of these vegetables and this body. The body is full of enzymes. A list of enzymes can be very, very long.
So these stress elements we derive to operate. And when you are deficient, by wrong choice, you go to hospital, nobody will find out anything, but the body is just suffering, except you have a lab that does enzyme tests. Not because you have a borehole in your appendices, you just drink it higher. Use sachet water because all the sachet water
factories,
they are examined by NAFTA. They have filters, they have ozonization, they go through all the processes of water purification. I'm much happier when you are away from sinks and regular applications when necessary. This gives you happiness that you have no moral debt to settle and makes you not to fear debt.
Number 11.
I praise pathological health. All I have to say here is cry and go for checks as long as you know. As you go, try. If you have any funny symptoms you cannot understand, go to a consultant medical office. Then after giving medicine, they spend another 6 to 7 years to study a particular aspect of medicine. And whatever system you come up with, they will be able to tell you.
Thank you, bro. Shame to you. And I think I'm up to you also, can you bring my one presentation? I can never also get it to have. And if I am, can you recall our great presentation? You know that you have to be
ladies and gentlemen, because I own Naga, and I clap up to support award on behalf of my brother and family. Speak around the mouth of the speaker, I call him Naga. In the fire, move on.
A late brother. Unfortunately, there was a tribute. I don't know what has happened. That was where I expressed gratitude for something happened. So, yes, should have appeared in the brochure. So I want to say thank you very much for this honor done to me. And I think he's also here because he's feeling just. Thank you very much for recognizing the service. And we say continue this good work that we have started. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Please, a hand round of applause for Professor Fabian Chukwueze. Okay, tonight, this award of honor to Professor Andrew Chukwueze. Please, a hand of applause.
This is a double barrel because I know I'm looking my work now to come up again. Please, the chairman or president of to the Father in India. Recognize Reverend Kama Benedict Ifeanyi Ugodo, Okunike, between 2008 and 2011. Ladies and gentlemen, let's present an award of honor to Reverend Kama Benedict Ifeanyi Ugodo. By the class of 1997, CJC Ugodo. Congratulations, sir. This is Verosa Osamo, born in Lagos. Every state, and of course, she spent 10 years in CKC. I present to you an award of honor to Mrs. Veronica Osamo, and the class of 1997 of the CKC Sports Association, recognition of her wonderful contribution towards our formation. Congratulations, sir.
In the sense that it's now going to spur them to to do more work. So what it is needed is going to support a lot of other teachers who are still in the process for better work.
Also, go now, sir. Yes, you find retired in 2017 after 33 years of service in the beautiful teaching tradition profession. Of course, he served as guest of the student from 1983 to Mr. Aranya Leonard Onyekuru. One of the founder by the class of 1997 of CJC Open Association, recognition of his wonderful contribution towards our profession. Congratulations, sir.
Yes. we meet you, sir.
Okay, I still remain my humble self, Dr. Ifechika Charles Odidi, National Secretary, CKC Good Boys Worldwide.
Today, the class of 97 of CKC marks their 25th anniversary,
Silver Jubilee.
What do you have to tell us about this?
Well, I have to always encourage them. You know, the younger sets, CKC, they have the culture of bringing old boys together. Like I said, I'm the National Secretary of CKC Old Boys Worldwide. I always encourage them because it's good to have a reunion of classmates, of friends, of well-wishers, and I encourage them to be united so that they will form a one for one group and so that they fight the one-to-one war. I believe in one thing, that whatever going to be, it will be. You see, the only thing you grow up to know is people you grow up with in your secondary school days. That's why you should encourage them and ask them to help those that are that I need. Those that are well to do should come down the road and help those that I need. And with that alone, we achieve success. CKC has come to stay. Since 1933, we are here. We are still struggling and we are still struggling harder. And I believe God, we are celebrating our 90th birthday this year, in November 25th. CKC do their 90th anniversary. It's a wonderful project because everybody in CKC, both in Europe, America, well to do, will be here in November.
And what is your word of encouragement to those who have not joined? I mean those old boys who have not yet joined the old boys.
My brother, they are missing a lot. Because I'll tell you the truth. It's because of CKC that I served under Willie Obiano administration. I was the SAC on special duty to him. Because of CKC. Because of CKC, I've gone to America, I've gone to Europe, because of CKC. The business I had in my passport here, because of CKC. Because I will be in another embassy, they will say, when you do school, I say, CKC, oh, that's a wonderful school. They should come to Old Boys Association and join. First of all, come to the mother branch before you now join your sets. You will gain a lot as the gospel truth.
Thank you very much, sir. Your name once again?
Honorable Dr. Ifechika.
Honorable.
Most welcome.
Brother, I greet you.
Yeah.
Can we meet you?
Yeah, I am ex-state manager and surveyor, Obi Aloikin Samuel. I'm the chairman of CKC, 97 seats.
Today your set marks 25th anniversary, the Silver Jubilee.
Yes.
And tell us how you feel today.
I feel very happy. Yeah, I feel more than happy. It's a thing of joy to meet my colleagues. My boys, I call them, because we're all boys, you know. Though we are men now, but then, 25 years ago, even 32 years ago, because it started from 1991, when we were very little, nobody knew we would be like this. But we thank God that today, we've evolved and become men. So it's a thing of joy. From all around Nigeria, we all came back together to witness this day. So we thank God. It's not all of us that's here, that's been there from the beginning.
So how would you assess the Silver Jubilee, the organization and everything?
It's okay, it's nice. We really tried. Both from the chairman, me, the organizing committee, the members, so they really tried because I can't do it alone. Even the organizing committee cannot do it alone. So without their support, I don't think we will have something like this. So I really thank us, the members, for their dedication, their support, and every other thing, both financially, morally. I thank them. So it's a success for us.
And you invited the friends, teachers, and well-wishers, and they graced the occasion. What is their word of appreciation to them?
Yeah, I thank everybody that came, that graced this occasion, because it's not easy to invite somebody and the person will come. There are some of them who were invited and they didn't make it. So I thank every one of them that came and made the occasion a success. And I pray as they came, when they are going back, the Lord, the good Lord will be with them. They will go successfully without any problem. And their families will welcome them. And God will be with us in Jesus' name.
Amen. Your name once again.
I'm still estate manager and surveyor. Palu and surveyor, Ikin and Samuel Obia.
Thank you very much.
They popularly call me Ike Bruno. Then when I was in CKC, I am Bruno, you know?
Hey Bruno.
Yes.
Yeah, let's know your name, please. Yeah? Your name, please.
Okay, I have a mobile engineer. Okay, that would be all right.
Yeah, that class of 2007.
Class
19. CKC. Melo. 25th anniversary, Silver Jubilee.
Papa, you say, Norma, I do a rap school and one, Amala Malo, Nani Bonine, Nigeria Nine, Nako Wanine, and Apo, Christy, where's the college? Kedino Nicha, Nana Brastate, Nime Nigeria, the West Africa, no one.
Kego be swearing over Singadata. Kego be swearing over Singadata. So in Africa, no galen koma.
Everything galen. Fucking no worry about any buffet. When I see grade, I'm big grade. 8, 85.
Galo kazi, on walo kuna ane mo na ega to Bolonde class uno. Ega ta ta uno men 25 years.
Ina ya, ina ede na platform ay, ede na remat na okuna mo bisi.
Engineer Peter Obiora, God bless you.